Now, what is complex substituents? You see, suppose I'll write down this example. Heading, write down complex substituents. Complex substituents are those substituents or branch which contains branch. Branch contains branch in this. Okay. Suppose this example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. And at this position, we have this group. This is okay. Can you tell me the longest chain?
So it'd be the one from the bottom.
There's one from the bottom. You know when it's like the
eight. Right.
This is the one.
Right. Can you tell me the name of this compound? Where's 2-methyl?
That's not a methyl, it's a complex.
4-methyl.
It's something else.
Is it 4 ethene 2?
No.
4
4 in bracket. 4 in bracket. 2 methyl ethene.
Octane.
Ethene.
Octane.
What?
2 methyl.
2 methyl. So is it
propyl?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Who said N5? See here, one thing. The parent, stop talking. The parent chain is this, right? And this group is attached to the parent chain. Right? Now, in this group, you see the rule is what? To number this substituents, actually, the substituents, you can either take this as the parent chain in the substituents or this as the parent chain in the substituents. You see this look? This is attached to the parent chain. You can either take this as the parent chain. If you take this as the parent chain, this becomes a substituent of the substituents. Okay. So if I take this as 1 or 2, then this will be methyl is the substituent of this ethyl group. Correct? If you take 1 and 2 here, then this methyl becomes the substituent of this ethyl group. Right? So you see the branch is what? Suppose if I take this example, suppose the simpler one is this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And here we have this group present. What is this? Ethyl? Right? Now in this ethyl, one hydrogen here is replaced by with what? One methyl group. Right? So this methyl is the branch of this substituent. Right? So the branch itself contains branch. So this substituent is what? It is complex substituents.
So which one would you consider the branch?
Wait, money. It's complex substituents. Complex substituents, you understood, right? Branch itself contains branch. Now, in this, the rule is what? To name this complex substituents, you have to start the numbering in this complex substituents from the carbon atom which attached with the parent chain. Okay, we cannot start from this carbon. 1, 2, 3, nickel something. Right? We have to start from this carbon, the carbon atom with which the parent chain is attached, right? So if this is 1, you can take either this as 2 or this as 2. 1, 2, 3, you can do it because continuous we have to write down the numbering, right? So if it is 1, this is 2 or this is 2. If this is 2, this methyl is the substituent of this, okay? So the name of this compound, if you want to write, we know the position of this complex substituents. That is what? That is at fourth position. Okay? So fourth, four dash, here we'll have the name of complex substituents. Okay? And then, how many carbon atoms? 8, so it is octane. Okay? You can write this bracket or you, if you do not write, that is also fine here. Simply dash also you can give. Right? So four dash, one methyl, right? 1 methyl and how many carbon atom in the complex substituents? 1, 2. So it is ethyl, not ethane. 1 methyl ethyl octane. Okay? So 1 methyl ethyl is the name of this complex substituent. The position of this complex substituent is 4th position. So 4-1 methyl ethyl octane is the name of this compound.
So there's a space between ethyl?
No, 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 there's no space.
So the only propyl.
Huh?
The only propyl.
propyl kaise hoga?
Sir, because you take the numbering from that carbon that's attached to the parent chain.
See, if it is propyl, then what is this?
It was just one branch.
If it is propyl, then what is this? What is this then? Is this propyl?
That is
propyl. 1, 2, 3. Where is
the one there also?
It is in the parent chain.
It's part of the parent chain.
We are already counting this in this. No, that's why we don't need here. Okay. So this one is propyl. 1, 2, 3. If this is propyl, this cannot be propyl. The purpose of IUPAC nomenclature is what? Each and every compound will have a different name. Right? If this is propyl, this is not propyl. But this one is not propyl. Why? Because we have to start numbering from the carbon atom of the complex substituents, which is attached with the parent chain. Clear? Right? So in case of this complex substituents, this di term, di, tri, tetra, if you write, that will consider an alphabetical sequence. Okay, don't ask me why, it is the rule. I said what? When the complex substituents we have, then di, tri, tetra will consider in alphabetical sequence. Okay? In simple substituents, di, tri, tetra are not, we won't consider that into the alphabetical sequence. That's why here you see D, ethyl and methyl we have. So E and M we are comparing. Right? Now some other examples. Did you copy this one? I'll write down some other examples. Tell me the name of this one.
So the parent chain is the one that goes up.
That's what you have to recite that. That.
No name.
Decane, undec, dodec. 12. Which is the parent chain here?
The one that comes from
R. This, right? See, so this is also 9 carbon. And if you start from here, this is also 9 carbon. But this chain has more number of substituents. See, I'll write down. If you take this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, how many substituents we have? 2. One is this, other one is this, right? Now if you number from this side, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. How many substituents? 3. One is this, other one is this, other one is this methyl, right? That's why the correct numbering is this, parent chain is this. More number of substituents, right? Now see here, at second position we have one methyl group, fourth position we have propyl group, and fifth position we have this complex substituents. This is complex, right? Because at this fifth carbon, we can take this as first, the carbon which attached with the parent chain, first carbon. Now we can take this as 2, or this as 2, or this as 2. Suppose I'll take this one as second. The name of this is 1,1 dimethyl ethyl. Okay? So the position of this is 5. Dimethyl ethyl we have here. This is propyl and this is methyl. Ethyl, propyl, methyl. Which one we should write first? First we write ethyl, then methyl, and then propyl. So the name of this compound is, at 5th position, we have 1,1 dimethyl ethyl. Then we'll write 2 methyl
So would that be for a 3 methyl propyl?
It's not a complex.
It's not a complex.
Are you alright? Tico, what's going on again? This is not a complex substituency. 1, 2. So at second position we have only methyl. Ah, ethyl. It's not there, no? Understood, right? Okay.
So briefly, we got 1,1 dimethyl.
So 2 carbon, right? So ethyl. And at first we have 2 methyl group. So 1,1 dimethyl. This one?
Yeah.
This is the parent chain, is this? This is the parent chain, right? So it is one substituent, another substituent, another substituent. What?
So the name is longer than the compound. What's the point of naming it? You just draw the compound.
Don't snag it, you won't get marks. The worst case is what? You lose 4 marks.
Reason why is because geo files are large.
Yeah, Nitesh, follow.
That's the answer, sir.
Correct.
It's
sent
by.
Huh?
It's
sent
how?
Oh. This one.
So, not because of that. Because in this complex substituent, the parent chain has 2 carbon atoms. So it is ethyl. So we have to write this in the last. All the parent chain, the carbon atom and the parent chain will write in the last one, known as. So if you name only this, it will be 1,1 dimethyl ethyl. Because 2 methyl group are the substituents. The chain is this ethyl. Yeah, but there is no other substituents here. Suppose if you write down here one chlorine present, or suppose if I write down iodine, I like this. So, what do you think? 1,1 will write dimethyl first, because then this dimethyl and iodine we are comparing. Right? But we have only one substituent, one kind of substituent, that is dimethyl only. So here that thing is not there. Yes, so parent chain is 2 carbon, so ethyl for that. It is not the substituent, it is the parent chain of this complex substituent. Okay?
This complex part gives priority.
What priority?
Does it come before?
What priority?
Does it come before? Everything else.
No, that will see only alphabetical sequence. Only alphabetical
sequence.
But if you place this here,
then there will be a compound.
Then
there
will change that.
There is no complex in this.
But what if I do this one?
Why do you have
that one also? That's a simple one.
from here we'll start the
So it'll be three
this is what you're talking about, right? We'll do this and then we'll see.
So it'll be three.
We'll do this and then. Okay, in this one we'll start numbering from which side?
So four.
This side? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, now at fourth position we have ethyl. And here we have methyl ethyl. So what we'll write here?
4 ethyl, 5, 1 methyl ethyl,
9.
Yeah, boy.
First we'll write ethyl or methyl ethyl?
Ethyl.
4
ethyl,
5 1 methyl,
ethyl,
ethyl, no name.
So, but in both the branches, aren't like isn't the complex one also the parent chain of the complex one as the ethyl?
Ah, that's what it is. That's okay, it is the parent chain of the complex substituents.
So, then how do you decide which ethyl comes first?
Both we have ethyl?
Yeah.
Then we compare this. M here. E comes first, then M. So in this one, the parent chain is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Simple one, right? Is this a complex substituent?
Yeah.
No.
So it is.
It is. It is. Okay. So the numbering is what?
5-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl-1-ethyl
one propyl.
Yeah, that's why.
Wait, it's one ethyl.
I have one ethyl, one propyl.
I have to say the one.
Thing.
So five,
yeah,
one ethyl,
one
ethyl propyl on it.
Yeah. One ethyl, one.
Oh, yeah, one ethyl.
Oh, it's a plus.
Yes. Is it from one name? It's going to be one ethyl, methyl propyl.
Yeah, it'll be ethyl, methyl propyl.
No, but the ethyl and methyl are
in brackets.
You need to put one for one.
Yeah, that. You have to put the one between them.
Oh, yeah.
Correct.
One
methyl profile, one methyl
profile.
No, profile is one only. You cannot write twice. Done?